And then out comes Maxwell Jacob Friedman. No more Better Than You, Bebe. No more Adam Cole. No more stupid devil mask. No more goofy kangaroo kicks.
It was funny that much of his promo was about getting rid of all of this crap, which actually was stuff that he came up with, which was over. So I was like, what? Vinny and I are here in Las Vegas. We got the Bellagio here in the background. You might actually get to see the Fountain show as we're doing this recording here today. I think the main takeaway is it was too long.
Absolutely.
There actually were people sitting near us that had to catch a flight. Yeah. And when it went past 9 o'clock, they left and missed Anarchy in the Arena because they had to get to their flight. I think this was the best match on the show.
I don't think there's any question.
No.
This match was awesome.
Yes, this match was so good that when it was over, I thought, you know what? If they just like said, see you next time, Vegas, and like let everyone go home, I think that 75% of the people would have been satisfied.
And then out comes Maxwell Jacob Friedman. He was blatantly wearing a knockoff of the jacket Triple H wore when he came back from his torn quad. No more Better Than You, Bebe. No more Adam Cole. No more stupid devil mask. No more goofy kangaroo kicks.
It was funny that much of his promo was about getting rid of all of this crap, which actually was stuff that he came up with, which was over. So I was like, what? Yeah, this Juice Robinson. This guy's a weird guy. I don't know if you ever noticed that. He's a weird guy, and he's kind of he's a very unique-looking guy. Somehow he came back even more fucking weird than he was before he left. He was
excited.
He was juicy.
He was juicy.
This is what he was.
Yeah, yeah.
Adam Copeland did get hurt.
That sucks.
I think Copeland got cold feet, and he decided he was going to just jump down, and he like jumped to do an elbow, and he landed on both feet. This guy's 50, I think.
Yep, half a century old.
You cannot jump off a cage and land on 2 feet. Someone got mad at me on Twitter because I mentioned that Mercedes did not look like her foot was at 100%. I don't know why people get mad at me. Like, I didn't say anything negative about the match at all, but, like, she wasn't cleared, like, a few weeks ago. So how could her leg possibly be 100%? It should be noted that this match had tremendous heat.
Absolutely. This had the most heat of anything on the show. This crowd believed, after much smoke and mirrors and shenanigans, that Christian Cage was actually going to pin Swerve
yes.
and win the world title. They were fooled by an earful.
They did a hell of a job.
For that reason and that reason alone, this match was an unqualified success. Anarchy in the Arena, or as I termed it online, Eternity in the Arena. This thing went forever.
When they hit the final countdown and these dudes are brawling all over the place, and Darby climbs up onto this big fucking thing. I actually got goosebumps. Look at that.
You do.
From thinking about
this. Like the Rock, you do.
Yeah.
Darby sets Jack Perry on fire.
He has a flamethrower, and he's fucking blasts Jack Perry's legs with his flamethrower. And it's not just like for a second and they put him out. It's like
he's running back and forth with his legs on fire.
He's running around, and Darby's like shooting him with this thing. Vinny is the YWF World Heavyweight Wrestling champion.
You won the thumb wrestling because of your judo practicing a very strong grip strength you have.
My
tendon strength.
My massive musculature.
Sure, sure.
And then Vinny won musical chairs.
Yes.
Because of his large ass.
Dominant size and girth.
I've never seen such a height disparity in living people. Final match was Oreo stacking. I won't lie, I got cocky.
It was very close.
Yes, I got cocky and I lost. You did get to chop John. He was a good sport. He took 7 chops.
He took 7 chops, which was...
They mostly sucked.
I don't think that's true at all.
And the sweet party, which was fun up until I left, and then apparently it...
It was fun. Well, to say it was fun and move on.
Yeah. It was fun for most everybody, but there was an incident.
It was fun for most everybody most of the time.
Yeah, nobody got hurt. And then we had...
Everyone's fine. Everyone
fine.
Turned out fine.
I want to know what happened. It was...
Someday, someone could come on this show and give their side of the story, perhaps.
Was there a fight?
There was not a fight.
Close?
There was just a lot of drinking in the wee hours of the morning at the sweet party. And probably some people... Here's an old saying. They overshot their target.
Yeah.
They should have been teetotalers. Teetotalers?
Teetotalers, yes.
Is that what it is? Not T2-tallers?
Yes.
Oh, damn it. I've been saying it wrong the whole time. This is the worst fucking blue screen I've ever seen. They like got a picture of somewhere in London. Fucking camera zooms out, and this fucking guy is in London.
Yeah.
I've never seen a guy somewhere where it looks so fake.
Mick Foley's in the ring. He was wrestling as Jack Foley.
I believe there was even a Jack Foley graphic.
Then introduced him at 147 pounds. Gorilla is appalled. Kirk Hoffman weighs 253 pounds.
And Gorilla goes, look at Kirk Hoffman. He's surely gotten broken ribs. And I'm like, who the fuck is Kirk Hoffman? What the fuck are you talking about, dude?
He also referred to Kamala's handler as Chip Chi. We thought we were done with babyface Mercedes Moné.
No.
Nope, nope. She comes here, cuts a straight babyface promo.
I know people will get mad about this. She's John Cena. She is a babyface, but they are well aware that she's going to get booed. I will say that, you know, some people were upset that Swerve gave Killswitch so much. I actually, in this instance, I disagree. Killswitch is a giant dinosaur who also is very much protected. He's only done two singles jobs since 2022.
TV time with the Learning Tree.
Yes. They have this fucking giant tree straight out of Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood.
Thank you.
Yep. Or Daniel Tiger, except yeah. That's animated. This giant fucking ridiculous tree.
We are 80 plus minutes into the show when someone mentions, oh, by the way, MJF is back.
Yeah, it wasn't there. I did hear that. I'm not going to say it. Go on.
The Elite come out for a promo.
I don't need to deal with this kind of stuff.
There's Okada Cat. Been around a long time. Won a bunch of awards. I don't know if he has ever entertained me more than he did in this segment. The crowd is chanting something. I forget what. I actually think it was for Punk. But he grabs the mic and he says, hey, hey, hey. Shut up, bitches. And everyone laughs and cheers and lets them know. Jet black Lamborghini is driven up. Has Rainmaker on the license plate. And Okada is moved to the point of tears. Oh my God. Oh my God. Is this a dream? Is this a dream? Thank you. I love you guys. And he covers his eyes and goes back to Stoneface.
And the fans chant, you deserve it.
You deserve it. Okada on AEW and American TV, the best.
This Tony Khan character is a goddamn fucking maniac. And he has created this match, which is fucking chaos. Who's in it? Doesn't matter. What are the intervals? Fuck off. I'll tell you. I'm just going to hit that goddamn music when it's time. They need to find a better name than the Casino Gauntlet. I wish they could say the Clusterfuck, but they need to say, next Wednesday, the Clusterfuck's coming. And you're like, oh man, fucking just nuttiness. Like, who's going to be in it? Who fucking knows? Like, when are the intervals? I don't know. How long is the goddamn thing going to go? Who knows? I don't know what the fuck's going on.
It seems way too early for either of these men to lose.
So the fact that they're not doing it at Wembley tells you Swerve is winning, okay? So then the next question is, well, are they doing a rematch at Wembley? If they're doing a rematch at Wembley, like, it's just bizarre because how does Ospreay go from losing to getting a rematch? And the idea people have mentioned is, well, he wins the Owen Cup. And yes, for those of you wondering, we are going to have an Owen Hart Cup and a tournament for the TNT title. So we have a men's tournament, a women's tournament, and a TNT title qualifying match tournament. Three going on in June.
Hmm. And Vic Joseph screams at me, how our night kicks off with our general manager, Ava. I could hear thousands of remote controls changing channels around the globe.
You know what's funny, Vinny? Yeah. Didn't happen.
I know.
This show did a gigantic number.
I heard that, actually.
Yeah. And I think it was because of Sexyy Red.
I would assume.
This NXT beat last week's Dynamite.
Wow.
And in 18-49, it virtually tied this week. Sexyy Red and Tatum had a tug of war, and Sexyy could not win that tug of war.
No.
But later, Sexyy had a tug of war with Mark Coffey, and she won.
Yeah, she outpowered him.
Yes. So Mark Coffey is the third strongest individual behind Sexyy Red, Tatum Paxley.
And so Lola says, you'll find out how dangerous I am firsthand. And Ariana says, oh shit! And yes. I howled. They bleeped it, of course, and put an NXT graphic over her mouth. Kelly interviews the OC. They warn the Masked Hoot and Quick Brother. The beatings will continue.
Excuse me?
That's what we called them.
The Masked Hoot?
And the Quick Brother.
What?
That's what they said.
Are you sure?
Positive. 100%.
Did you put that closed captioning on?
Swear to God, I was listening.
The masked hoot?
Yes.
Jiminy Christmas. You ever looked at this Urban Dictionary? They got like 50,000
definitions
of hoot. A toke of marijuana smoke. Hoot this bowl.
Hoot this bowl would be a great NXT chant.
The sound an owl makes.
Hoot this bowl. Hoot this bowl.
They have an example for the sound an owl makes. Owl. Hoot. Human. Hoot. Owl. Hoot. Got it?
Jordan Grace's music hits and her name appears on the screen and the place goes crazy.
They sure fucking did.
And Vic says, holy eh! And then later, holy sh! And there's TNA chants at the WWE Performance Center.
Yeah.
And Jordan cuts the best promo on the show. Ethan Page is in the ring. He wipes out Trick, who bonks into Lash, takes her out. And Vic says, wasn't he in AE? And it was actually perfectly timed, because I heard about this line, but he gets to the E, and then before he can get to the W, Ethan has the mic and is talking now. So he interrupted Vic before he could get to W. So he says, yes, I'm the one who took out Noam. I took out Oro. And now I'm going to whip that Trick. He hits a knee in the corner and poses with a belt. And there you go. Ethan Page versus Trick Williams. Battleground. They needed a top guy. Badly.
I like this show.
I'm glad you enjoyed the show.
Yeah. 2 weeks in a row, it's been much better than it had been in the past.